Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So today is the very auspicious day of the disappearance of Srila Haridas Thakur.
非常吉祥的印记日.
Usually, the disappearance of the Vaishnavas is very painful and confidential, and it's not discussed usually in the scriptures.
通常，因为Vaishnava的隐迹是非常机密，而且是令人痛苦的，所以经典一般不谈，一般不讨论。
But the disappearance of Haridas Thakur is so glorious that there's one chapter there in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. So from the life of Haridas Thakur, we see how much he tolerated difficulties and obstacles in the course of his chanting of the holy name. Because Haridas Thakur appeared in a Mohammedan family, so it was very unusual for a Mohammedan to chant the holy name of Krishna, because Krishna is considered Hindu god.
Haridas Thakur was born in a Muslim family, so a Muslim to sing Krishna's name.
Sometimes I go to preach in Islamic countries, and in Islamic countries, it's a law that someone who's a Mohammedan, they cannot change their religion. It's an offense which can be punishable by death. So, when Haridas Thakur was chanting the holy name, there was some criticism from the local Qazi, the Mohammedan ruler. He saw that this Haridas Thakur, he is from a Mohammedan family, but he's chanting the Hindu name. So the Qazi went to the king of that country and he complained to the king. So the king ordered the arrest of Haridas Thakur. He had to be brought to brought before the king. King wanted to know what's going on. So, when Haridas Thakur was brought the court. At that time, there were many other prisoners, and they also desired to see Haridas Thakur. They heard that this Haridas Thakur, Haridas, had been brought there, and they understood he was a great saintly person. And so they desired to see him and to get blessings from him.
When 他们也很渴望能见到这位伟大的圣人，因为他们都对他早有耳闻，他们想见这位圣人，得到他的祝福。
So it was arranged that Haridas was brought before the other prisoners, and Haridas Thakur saw them all in the prison cells, in custody, and he gave blessing to them. He said,May you stay as you are. So when they heard this, they were not very happy.
于是便安排把哈尔达斯塔库带到了这些囚犯的面前，这是在监牢里。于是哈尔达斯塔库就祝福这些囚犯说，愿你们还继续待在这个牢房里。当这些囚犯听说了这个祝福，心里一点也不高兴
了。But then Haridas Thakur explained to them what he meant when he said like this.
随后 Haridas Thakur 就解释他这句话的意思是什么。
And he told them, he said, I'm not talking about your physical situation, I'm talking about your mental situation.Because I see that while you're here in this situation, you're not thinking about sense gratification. Your mind is not absorbed in just thinking of enjoying material life.
Haridas Thakur 就跟他们解释说，我指的并不是你们的身体状况，而指的是你们的心意状况。当你们待在这个牢房里的时候，你们不会想到感官享乐，你们的心意丝毫也不会想到这些物质的感官享乐。
Haridas Thakur said, "You're going to get free from this prison in a few days. Don't worry, but when you get out, try to remember to keep your mind detached from thoughts of material sense gratification."
Haridas Thakur 继续说道。不要担心，过几天你们就会出狱了。但是等你们出狱之后，要记住你们的心意，不要想着物质的感官享乐。
All problems in life come because of sense gratification, because of our uncontrolled senses. They bring us so many miseries in our lives.
一切问题的根源都出在。感官享乐，我们想要满足我们的感官，这样会带来种种的痛苦。
So if you can restrain your senses and control your mind, give up all thoughts of sense gratification, you'll live a peaceful, happy life.
如果你们约束感官，控制心意，放弃这些不恰当的念头，你内心就会感到平和快乐。
So then Haridas was brought before the king, and the king wanted to know. He said, you know, you're born in a Mohammedan family, which is very good. It's very high class to be born in a Mohammedan family. But you're chanting the names of the Hindu god. Why are you behaving like a Hindu when you're born in a Mohammedan family? You're so fortunate, you have such a good birth in a Mohammedan family. Why are you taken to this Hindu culture?
哈尔达斯塔库被带到了国王的面前，国王对哈尔达斯塔库说道，你出生在一个穆斯林家庭，这是一个很高等的出生，为什么你唱诵了一个印度神的名字，为什么你接受了一个印度教，你是这么幸运，你有这么好的出生，能够成为一个穆斯林， 可是你为什么接受了印度教呢？
So Haridas Thakur explained to the king, he said, God, there's one God for everyone, but he has many different names according to different cultures, different traditions. But there's only the one Supreme Lord for everyone. It's just that we give him different names. God is not Hindu or Muslim or any of these different faiths. He's the one Supreme Lord who's the controller of everyone.
Haridas Thakur 就解释说，只有一个神，但是因为对于不同的人呢，他就显现了不同的名字，就根据不同的文化、不同的传统，这同一位神、同一位至尊主，他以不同的名字而出现在不同的文化、不同的传统、不同的人面前。但是神只有一个至尊主，不论一个人他是印度教徒、穆斯林或是什么信仰，他只有一位至尊主，他控制所有的人。
And Haridas went on to explain how we're all the servants of that one Supreme Lord. And there's no difference in whether one serves a Hindu God or a Muslim God, it's the same. We're all the servants of that one Supreme Lord, and our goal of life is to develop love for the Lord.
他又解释说，我们所有的人都是这位至尊主的仆人，没有什么区别，无论是印度教徒还是穆斯林都是一样的，我们都是这位至尊主的仆人，所有的目标都是为了爱神。
So the king was impressed, but the Qazi, the local Qazi had come, and the local Qazi was saying to the king that this is very bad, he's giving up his good birth as a Muslim to become a low-class Hindu. He said, for this offense, it should be punishable by death.
国王呢，就对哈尔达斯塔库的解释，留下了深刻的印象。可是呢，当地的这个卡西又过来说，这个不好，这个哈尔达斯塔库他放弃了他自己的高等出生，他转而接受了一个低等的印度教。由于他这个冒犯，他应当受到惩罚，应当被处死。
So the king said, "We give you the choice." He said that you simply have to confess that you should. There's a section in the Quran where one prays to the Lord, prays to Allah to be forgiven for his sinful reactions of giving up the Muslim faith. And in this way, he can be forgiven. He just has to chant these prayers from the Quran and he can be relieved of his sins. And then he can continue like this as a Muslim. So they told Haridas, you should read this section of the Quran. In this way, you can be free of sins and keep your Muslim faith.
国王就对哈尔达斯塔库说，现在呢，你有这个选择，你可以认罪。在古兰经当中呢，有这个部分，你向神向你祈祷，祈求至尊主原谅你的所有罪恶反应，由于你放弃了你的穆斯林信仰。你要恳求得到宽恕，这样呢，你就摆脱了你的所有冒犯，你可以继续你的穆斯林，作为穆斯林教徒的身份。换言之呢，就是在古兰经当中呢，有这样一句祈祷文，你哈尔达斯塔库呢，应该读这段祷文之后就免除了冒犯。
But Haridas Thakur said, even if my body is cut to pieces, I can never give up chanting the holy name of the Lord.
可是哈尔达斯塔库却回答说，即便我被碎尸万段，也会放弃唱诵主的圣名。
So seeing his determination to keep chanting Hare Krishna, the king decided that he should be beaten in market in 22 market all the marketplaces, 22 marketplaces. He should be beaten with sticks. In other words, he should be beaten to death.
唱诵 Hare Krishna， 这国王就决定要把 Haridas Thakur 拖到所有的22座市场， 用鞭子抽打他， 抽打致死。
So in this way Haridas Thakur was then taken into the marketplaces and they began beating him.
就这样 Haridas Thakur 被拖到市场上， 他们就开始鞭打他。
When the people saw Haridas Thakur being beaten, then all the local people, they were very disturbed. They thought, this is very sinful, this is very terrible, how they can beat Haridas like this.
当地人看到Haridas Thakur被鞭打的这一幕，内心都感到非常的不安，他们认为这是非常有罪的，太可怕了，他们怎么这样对待Haridas Thakur。
They said, certainly our country will suffer reactions for this. There will be famine, there will be droughts, there will be plagues, there will be disasters, because this is so sinful. We will be, all be punished for this sin of offending Haridas.
由于罪恶，就会有饥荒，有洪水，瘟疫，有种种的灾难。 由于他们犯下了这种罪行，我们都会一同遭殃的。
Now usually when people are beaten, they will die after two or three marketplaces because the beating is so painful and severe that people will die after being beaten in two or three marketplaces. But somehow Haridas Thakur survived, and one place after another, he continued to chant the holy name.
两三个市场被鞭打之后呢，就会被鞭打致死。可是哈尔达斯塔库尔在所有这个市场被鞭打之后，他却仍然幸存了下来。他继续在唱诵着圣名。And
the people beating him became very disturbed that if we're not able to kill Haridas, we will be punished. So when Haridas heard that they would be punished for not killing him, then Haridas Thakur entered into a state of samadhi, deep, almost like unconscious state, and they thought that now he's dead.
因为如果哈尔达斯塔库没有被惩罚致死的话，他们就会打手就会被受到惩罚。当哈尔达斯塔库听说打手的这些话之后呢，他便进入了一种samadhi，就是无知觉的一种状态，就好像死了一样。So
they brought his body before the king and they showed the king. They said, look, see, he's dead. Now he's dead. So there was some discussion, should he be buried? So the Qazi said, no, we shouldn't bury him, because if we bury him, then he will get a good life in the future. He'll get a better life in the future. He said, but he's been very sinful, so we shouldn't give him the honor of being buried. We will just simply throw his body in the Ganga.
向国王展示说，看他已经死了。于是呢，就开始讨论该怎么处置哈尔达斯塔库尔的躯体，是把他是埋葬他呢？这时候呢，卡西就站出来说，不能埋葬他。如果把他的尸体埋葬了，他就会得到一个更好的出生。可是他罪行累累。 如果他得到一个更好的出生，他反而受到了荣耀。不如把他的 尸体扔到恒河当中。
So they threw his body into the Ganga, and Haridas Thakur's body floated for some time, and then he came back to consciousness, and he came back out from the Ganga.
他们就把 Haridas Thakur 的身体扔到了，投进了恒河里。然后呢，这个他 Haridas Thakur 就顺着恒河漂浮了一段时间，他就恢复了知觉。
Now the king had actually said, he said, if you survive the beating, then we will understand you're really a saintly person. But if you die, then it proves you're not, this holy name, this chanting of yours is useless. So you prove to us the power of this holy name. And so when Haridas Thakur appeared again after the beating, then the king was very...He understood Haridas was really a great saintly person, and he fell at his feet and he asked forgiveness.
这之前呢，国王曾经说过，只要哈尔达斯塔库尔他能活下来，便能证明他确实是一个圣人。如果他要是死了的话，就证明这圣名是没有用处的。所以为了证实这个圣名的力量。达斯塔库尔就又再次出现在国王面前，这一下子呢，国王便明白哈尔达斯塔库尔是多么伟大的一个圣人，于是便倒在他的足下，恳求得到宽恕。
So the king told Haridas, he said, "You're free to go anywhere you like to chant the holy name. Anywhere within my kingdom, no one will disturb you."
国王告诉哈尔达斯塔库尔。你现在可以自由自在的，去我的国度，任何地方去唱诵圣名，没有人能阻挠你。
So Haridas, for some time he was living in a cave, and in the cave there was this terrible smell. It was a very burning sensation experienced by everyone who came in the cave.They could not understand what is wrong in this cave, that there's this burning sensation. It's like some kind of fire is going on in this cave. And they brought people to find out what was wrong, and then they found out there was a big snake. There was a big hole where a big snake was living, and the poison snake. So Haridas was sitting there chanting the holy name.
哈尔达斯塔库尔进入了一个山洞，就住在这个山洞里。但这个山洞里有一股就是灼烧的味道。当人们进入这个山洞的时候，就会不知道到底这种就是令人感到这种皮肤发烧的这种感觉是从哪儿来的。他们就到处寻找这种原因何在。最后他们发现。有一条巨蟒，有毒的巨蟒居住在这个蛇洞里，就是由于这个巨蟒的原因，人们就会感到他们皮肤有一种灼烧的感觉，而哈尔达斯塔库尔就住在这个山洞里唱诵圣名。
So people like to come to see Haridas and to offer obeisances to him, but they did not like that.Smell and the burning sensation there, and they were afraid when they heard there was a big snake there. So they asked Haridas that you please leave, this is not a good place for you. But Haridas said, well, I'm already living here several days. I don't feel any discomfort. I'm very fine, happy here. But he said, if you're feeling some discomfort, then for your sake, I can move. He said, tomorrow, if the situation doesn't change, I will move.
跟人们说，我只是在这里住几天而已， 我在这里住在这里，我并没有感到不舒服，但是呢，我感觉到住这里也很高兴。可是为了你们，如果明天这个情况还没有改变的话，我就会离开这个山洞。
But that same night, the snake crawled out of his hole and it left the cave, never to come back, because the snake didn't want to give inconvenience to Haridas Thakur. And everyone saw the snake. They saw this huge, it was a big snake and it was very colorful, with some blue and red, different colors in the skin of the snake. It came crawling out and it just went out of the cave and left because it didn't want to give any trouble to Haridas.
当晚，这条蛇就从它的洞穴当中爬出了这个山洞，永远离开了那里，因为它不想打扰哈尔达斯塔库的念诵。人人都看到了这条就是蛇皮色彩斑斓的蛇皮，有着色彩的斑斓的皮肤的巨蛇，就从这个山洞当中缓缓地爬出去，因为它不想打扰哈尔达斯塔库。
Because the Lord is in the heart of every living entity, so the Lord also within the heart of the snake was directing the snake that don't give inconvenience to Haridas Thakur. He's my devotee, he's chanting the holy name. You go some other place and find some other place to live. So there were many other challenges. People were envious of Haridas Thakur, just like sometimes people from Brahmana families, Brahmana caste, people born in Brahmana families. They thought themselves to be very high class, and they thought Haridas, because he's from a Mohammedan family, they thought him to be very low class.
Haridas Thakur 呢，除此之外还遇到其他的种种的挑战，比如说嫉妒，就有一些婆罗门的阶层的人士，他们诞生在 Brahman 的家庭当中，自认为是高人一等的，而Haridas Thakur 是出生于穆斯林家庭，是一个低等的出生。
So one time Haridas had gone to the home, the family of Raghunath Das, they were very wealthy people. Raghunath's father and his uncle, they were very, very wealthy, and they were giving charity to maintain all the brahmanas in that area. And so they invited Haridas Thakur to their home, and in their home they had this one brahmana who was doing the puja.
Haridas Thakur 被应邀就去 Raghunath Das 家。 Raghunath Das 的父亲和叔叔是非常腰缠万贯的富人，他们维持着这整个这片地区的 brahmana， 他们就邀请 brahmana 会到家中进食。在他们家中呢，有位 brahmana 是做 puja 的。
So while Haridas was in the home, they had some discussion about the chanting of the holy name. And Haridas Thakur explained that if you chant the holy name at the level of Namabhas, you get liberation. And so the brahmana who was there, he did not like that. He said, you think it's so easy to get liberation? You think just by chanting the name at Namabhas, the shadow of the name, you can be liberated? If you can get liberation so easily, my nose will fall off.
在这个家庭当中，在这家中呢，便有一番对于圣名的讨论。Haridas Thakur 解释说，在 Namabhas 唱诵圣名 ，Namabhas 阶段，一个人就可以得到解脱了。这个 Brahma 一听这个话呢，就感到非常不高兴，他就反问道，你觉得获得解脱那么容易吗？ 如果在那么巴斯阶段呢，唱诵那么巴斯阶段，一个人就能获得解脱这么容易的话，我的鼻子就会融化掉，掉下来。
For the Brahmanas, you know, the smarter Brahmana, that means Brahmana, the caste Brahmanas, their goal is often liberation. They are thinking liberation is the goal of life. But for a devotee, liberation is not so significant. We practice devotional service not for liberation, but to develop love of God.
Brahmana 就是这些 smart 种姓 Brahmana， 他们的生命目标呢，通常就是为了达到解脱。但是奉献者认为解脱并不是那么重要，修习奉献服务不是为了获得解脱，而是为了获得神爱。
So when this Brahmana had spoken so nastily in such nasty way to Haridas Thakur, then his employers, the father of Raghunath and his uncle, they told the Brahmana, you have committed a great offense against Haridas. This is very bad for you. You leave here. We don't want you in the service here anymore. You're dismissed from service here. Get out from this house. We don't want to keep an offender to the devotees here. So he was sent out of the house, and in a few days, his body became infected with leprosy. And his nose fell off.
一听到这位 Brahmana 这一番下流的尖刻的话语，这个主顾就是这个 Brahmana 的雇主，也就是 Raghunath Das 的叔叔和他的父亲，就当下就决定，由于这个 Brahmana 的冒犯，这种不良的冒犯，他应该立刻离开这个家庭。所以呢，他们就把这位 Brahmana 开除了，让他立刻滚出这个家庭。于是呢，这个 Brahmana 就被逐出了 Raghunath Das 的家庭。过了几天，这位 Brahmana 染上了天花麻风病，他的鼻子就从他的脸上就掉了下来，融化了。
Then another man who was envious of Haridas Thakur.He hired a prostitute to go there and seduce Haridas Thakur. But the result was that Haridas Thakur brought that prostitute into devotional service, and she gave up her sinful life and began to chant the holy name.
有另外一个就是心怀嫉妒的人，他就让一个妓女去引诱勾引 Haridas Thakur。可是结果，这位妓女转而从事奉献服务，放弃了她的罪恶生活，开始持诵圣名。
Then another time there was a discussion, an important discussion. One Brahmana was arguing with Haridas that why is it so necessary to chant the holy name loudly?Why can't you just chant in your mind? He said, the real meditation on mantras is done by silent meditation. We meditate in the mind. We don't chant loudly the way you're doing it.
还有另外一次呢，出现了一个争论，有一个讨论，有一名 Brahman 呢，就对 Haridas Thakur 说呢，有什么必要那么要高声的唱诵圣名呢？应该在心意里唱诵就足够了。你只需要默默的在心里念诵。真正的冥想是在心意里进行的，而不是像你这样的来进行这种冥想。
So Haridas Thakur said to the Brahman, he said, certainly it's in the scriptures. It's recommended that once you chant the holy name loudly. And Haridas Thakur went on to explain that there's a verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam, in the 10th canto, in relation to the liberation of Vidyadhara. Vidyadhara is a resident of the higher planets. And it describes how this Vidyadhara had been cursed by great sages to become a snake.
Haridas Thakur 回答说，在经典当中无疑就有这样的论断，应当大声的唱诵圣名。就在圣典博加瓦坛的有一个师节当中，第十篇就解释，当涉及到 Vidyadhara 的故事的时候，就解释的这一点。 Vidyadhara 是来自高等星宿的居民，就描述说，因为他做了冒犯，遭到一个圣人的诅咒，变成了一条蛇，一条巨蟒。
So it happened one night Nanda Maharaj was with the other Brijbasi men and they were camping out at the bank of, at the side of the Yamuna, and during the night this big snake came and began to swallow Nanda Maharaj.
Nanda Maharaj 和 Raja 一些 Brajbasi 他们有一天晚上就在外面露营，就在 Yamuna 河的岸边。当晚呢，有一条爬过来的一条巨蟒开始吞噬南达大军。
So Nanda Maharaj, he's in great danger. They tried to help him. They brought burning logs. The snake would not release him. When he called for Lord Krishna, Lord Krishna came, and he touched that snake with his left foot. And as soon as he touched that snake with his left foot, the demigod became a demigod again.
在危险当中呢，人们就是看拿来了那个燃烧的火棒，就开始击打这条巨蟒，但是却不能把它却不能怎么样它。在这种危险的境况当中，南达大军就开始呼唤 Krishna， 然后 Krishna 便出现了，用他的左脚就触碰了这条巨蟒，在经过触碰之后，这条巨蟒变成了一半神的身体。
So then the Vidyadhara told the people what happened, that he said, you know, I was cursed to take this body of a snake, but I see now that this is the mercy of the great sages, that they've put me into this situation. Now that I could get the mercy of Lord Krishna. He said, anybody who hears the holy name, and anybody who chants the holy name, and those who hear the holy name, they can be liberated. So what to speak of one who is touched by the foot of the Lord himself?
Vidyadhara 就解释说，就是他在众人面前，他就解释他遭到了诅咒，不得不投成为一条巨蟒，但是呢，他现在明白了，这是圣人的仁慈，使他处于这种境况，他可以得到Krishna的仁慈。那么，所有聆听到主的圣名的都可以得到解脱，更何况，唱就得到主本人的亲自触碰的呢
？Yeah, so.Haridas Thakur went on to explain that who is better, one who can maintain himself or one who can maintain 100 people. He said, if I chant the holy name in my mind, it's good for me, benefits me, but there's no benefit to other living entities. But when I chant the holy name loudly, then all those living entities who hear the holy name, then they're all benefited by hearing the holy name.So what's better, just to maintain myself or to help to maintain all others, to give the mercy of the holy name to everyone?
Haridas Thakur 就继续说道，那哪一个更好呢？是光是只是维持自己就好了呢？还是那个能维持100个人的人呢？在心意里唱诵圣名无疑是对自己有好处的。但是，大声的唱诵圣名，却是能够给所有聆听到圣名的生入都带来好处的。所以，哪一个更好呢？是那个仅仅维持自己的人，还是能够把这个仁慈也给予其他生物的人呢
？So this way, Haridas Thakur established the importance of the loud chanting of the holy name. Of course, the smarter Brahmins, those caste Brahmins, you know, they don't like it. They think this is not necessary. This is just disturbing us. There's even a saying that during the time of the Chaturmasya, the Lord is sleeping. And they say that if we chant the holy name loudly, then we're going to wake him up. And if we wake him up, he'll be angry. And if he's angry, then we will have a problem. There will be no good rain, and the food won't grow, and all the prices will go up. Food will be scarce. It will all be your fault because you're chanting the holy name so loudly. You disturbed him. So, this is the arguments of the smarter Brahmanas. They always oppose to the... Actually, the Lord is very pleased where his holy name is chanted. It is just these people, these orthodox people, that they don't like to see other people other than the Brahmanas have any chance of spiritual development. They think everything is only for the Brahmanas. Other people have no right to chant the holy name.
就这样呢，主对于那些唱诵他圣名的人是感到非常满意的。可是这些smart Brahmana是非常保守的，他们并不喜欢其他的人也有得到灵性进步的机会。他们认为呢，一切好处都应该给他们这些Brahmana，而别的人是没有权利得到这些机会的。
So, Haridas Thakur, by appearing in the Mohammedan family, he's showing everyone that birth is not the important criterion. The important thing is devotion, and the Lord is pleased where there's pure devotion. It doesn't matter what caste or what level of society you're born in, that's not the important factor. What the Lord wants to see is genuine devotion in chanting the holy name.
就这样，哈尔达斯塔库通过他诞生在布拉曼的家庭当中这一事实呢，就证明出身并不是一个人灵性进步的准则，衡量人们进步的标准。标准的是人们内心的奉爱，他们的纯粹的奉爱，而那些阶层、种姓和人们的出身并不重要。
So Haridas Thakur, he had a vow every day to chant 300,000 holy names. And he kept that vow for many, many, many years. And later on, he'd come to Jagannath Puri, and he was lived because Lord Chaitanya was in Jagannath Puri, and he was living also in Jagannath Puri. And Haridas Thakur would live on the beach. And because he could not go in the temple because he's from a Mohammedan family. He was not allowed in the temple, but he'd live on the beach. And he'd sit on the beach and he'd sit and chant the holy name there every day. And every day Lord Chaitanya would come and bring Mahaprasadam from Jagannath to give to Haridas. So it happened that one day Lord Chaitanya's servant came there with the Mahaprasadam to give to Haridas Thakur. And when he came there, he saw that Haridas Thakur was laying on his back and he was chanting the holy name, but he was chanting very slowly. So Govinda, the servant of Lord Chaitanya, said, "Please get up and come and take your Mahaprasadam." But Haridas said, "No, today I shall observe fasting." He said, "I want to fast today." He said, I have not finished chanting my rounds. So how can I eat?"
就来看哈尔达塔库发现呢他躺着在非常缓慢地唱诵着圣名那狗问他就对他说请起来荣耀马哈普沙的吧哈尔达塔库说不今天我要戒食因为我还没有完成我的圈数没有完成我的圈数我怎么能荣耀呢
But then Haridas Thakur said, "But you have brought Mahaprasadam, how can I refuse it? Because that's also not good. Somebody brings you prasadam, you should immediately accept it." So then Haridas Thakur offered some prayers and he took a little prasadam and ate it. Because Mahaprasadam is not different from Krishna. So he wanted to honor Lord Krishna in the form of prasadam.
说那既然你带来了马哈普沙丹拒绝也不好因为得到了马哈普沙丹就应该立刻就接受所以哈尔达塔库呢就荣耀了一点点马哈普沙丹吃下去了因为马哈普沙丹跟主Krishna没有区别所以呢他荣耀马哈普沙丹就是荣耀 Krishna
So then the next day, Lord Chaitanya came and he asked Haridas. He said, "Haridas, are you well?" And Haridas, he first offered his obeisances to Lord Chaitanya. And then he said, "Well, my body's all right, but my mind and my intelligence are not well." So then Lord Chaitanya asked him, "Do you know what your disease is? What's your problem?" And Haridas said, "Yes, my disease is I cannot complete my rounds." So Prabhupada explains, he said, in our Krishna consciousness movement, we also have this disease if we don't chant our rounds. So he said, we have given the devotees 16 rounds to chant, and these rounds should, they must be chanted, and they must be chanted loudly so that one can hear himself and let others also hear. So then Lord Chaitanya told Haridas, he said, now that your body has become old, you can reduce the number of rounds you chant loudly every day. He said, because I know you're chanting every day 192 rounds. So you're already liberated. You've been chanting so many rounds for a long time. You're already liberated. You do not need to follow so strictly now in your old age. So Haridas Thakur, he was very strict about following these principles. And Prabhupada says chanting the holy name is the first principle, the first regulative principle.
Haridas Thakur very strictly observed these principles. So, chanting the holy name is the first principle, the first regulative principle.
So Lord Chaitanya told Haridas Thakur, he said, I know you have come to deliver the people. In this incarnation, you have come to deliver the people. So when he said you're in this incarnation, he's indicating that Haridas Thakur is actually Lord Brahma, and sometimes he's called Brahma Haridas, that Lord Brahma came in the form of Haridas Thakur to chant the holy name.
主 Chaitanya 告诉 Haridas， 我知道你来前来是为了拯救世人，你化身而来的目的就是为了救赎世人。你是因为 Haridas Thakur 呢，他就是主 Brahma 化身，所以他有时候被称为 Brahma Haridas， 他唱诵圣名。
Great devotees like Lord Brahma, they come to help the Lord. When the Supreme Lord comes, they will come also to help the Lord in his mission. So Lord Brahma came as Haridas Thakur to assist Lord Chaitanya in propagating the chanting of the holy name of the Lord. So Lord Chaitanya pleads with Haridas, he said, please just be satisfied to chant less number of rounds, you don't need to chant so many. But Haridas Thakur said, no, listen, what is my real situation? He said, I am born in a very low family and my body is very contaminated and very untouchable. I'm very low and fallen among people. And he said that it's very kind of you to accept me as your servant.
主 Chaitanya 对 Haridas Thakur 的这番话都非常满意，他 跟哈尔达斯塔库说，你可以减少你的签数。哈尔达斯塔库对主回答说，我的真正境况是，我出生在非常低贱的家庭，我的躯体是受到污染的，我是非常低贱堕落的，但是您如此仁慈，你接受我为您的仆人。
Because you've accepted me as your servant, you saved me from a hellish life, and you've brought me to the spiritual platform.
因为您仁慈地接纳我为您的仆人，您把我从地狱的生活当中拯救了出来，把我提升到灵性的生命当中。
They said, Haridas Thakur said, you've made me do many things. You made me dance in many different ways. You got me to do many things. You got me to accept the Shraddha plate. When Advaita Acharya's father passed away, I had to take the Advaita Acharya gave the Shraddha plate to me. Although I'm so fallen and so unworthy, there were so many other brahmanas there.He could have given it to other brahmanas, but instead he gave it to me. He honored me, and you made me. You insisted I should accept it.
Haridas Thakur 对主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说道：“您让我做很多事情，您让我跳舞，就在对他 Chaya 的他父亲。”去世的时候的那个仪式上，是您让我接受了第一个接受了这个 Shraddha 的这个供盘。当时有很多众多的 Brahman 的都在场，可是您如此仁慈，您却就让我接受了这个 Shraddha 这一个盘供盘，使我得到了荣耀。
Yeah, that...
是您仁慈的接受了我。
That Shraddha plate should have been given to a first-class brahmana. And I'm born in a family of meat-eaters. I'm not a first-class brahmana, but they gave it to me.
通常这个 Shraddha 这个供盘呢，供品呢，是应该给那些一流的 brahmana 来荣耀的。但是呢，我出生在一个吃肉者的家庭。
So then Haridas Thakur said, I have one desire. He says that I think that very soon you're going to finish your own pastimes in this material world. So he said, I don't want to have to see you leave this world. I want to leave the world before you.
我现在有一个愿望，我知道不久的将来您就会结束您在这个物质世界的消时光，我不想见证您离开这个物质世界的消时光的场景，我希望在您离开之前就走。
So Haridas Thakur begged Lord Chaitanya and said, please allow me, let my body fall down in your presenceLet me leave my body in your presence.
Haridas Thakur 就恳求主 Chaitanya, 请允许我的躯体在您的面前倒下。我希望在您的面前离开躯体。
Yeah, I want to leave the world at your lotus feet and seeing your lotus face.
我希望在您的莲花足下离开这个世界，我希望在看着您的莲花脸离开。
And with my tongue, I will chant your name, Sri Krishna Chaitanya. He said, "This is my desire." And Haridas Thakur begged Lord Chaitanya, "Please give me this wish."
我希望用我的舌头唱诵您的圣名 Sri Krishna Chaitanya. 我希望。Haridas Thakur 就这样恳求主满足他的心愿。
So Lord Chaitanya said, well, he said, Krishna is merciful, then he must also give you what you want.
主 Chaitanya 回答道 ，Krishna 是仁慈的，他一定会满足你的愿望。
But Lord Chaitanya said, I am attached to your association. I don't want you to go away. If you go away, I'll be here. I'll be left behind. It's not, I don't want to be here without you. I need your association.
主 Chaitanya 对 Haridasa 护说，但是我依附你的联谊，我不希望你走，我不希望被留在你的身后，我不希望没有你的联谊，我的存在没有你的联谊，我希望得到你的联谊。
But Haridas Thakur pleaded with Lord Chaitanya. He fell at his feet. He said, you have so many nice devotees with you. There are so many great souls here with you. I am very fallen. I'm insignificant. You don't need me to stay here.
但是 Haridas Thakur 就对主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 他就拜倒在主 Chaitanya 的莲花足下说，你有那么多优秀的奉献者，那么多伟大的灵魂，而我是一个堕落的、微不足道的灵魂。您不需要我。
I'm just like an insect, and if some insect dies, then there's no loss to the world.
我就像一个小昆虫，倘若一只小昆虫死去了，这个世界也没有什么损失可言。
Haridas said, I'm not a real devotee, I'm just an imitation devotee. But still, I have this desire that if I can leave in that way, that will be very nice.
Haridas Thakur 就说，我不是一名真正的奉献者，我只是一名模仿的奉献者。我的愿望是，我希望以这种方式离开。
So then Lord Chaitanya, he left that day, and then he came back the next day. He went off to do his duty. He has to go take his bath every day in the sea. And then the next day, he came back again to see Haridas. The next morning, he came to see Haridas.With all the devotees, and he brought all the devotees with him.
Chu Chaitanya, 因为要有一些职责要履行，他要去海里沐浴，于是他便离开了。到次日的早晨，Chu Chaitanya就带着所有的奉献者再次来看望 Haridas Thakur.
And so Lord Chaitanya says, "Well, Haridas.What is the news?" And Haridas said, whatever mercy you can bestow upon me, he said, that is the news.
Chu Chaitanya 问 Haridas 有什么消息吗？ Haridas 他回答说，无论您给我什么样的仁慈，这就是我的消息。
So then Lord Chaitanya began the kirtan, and he had wonderful devotees with him, people like Vakreshwara Pandit, who is famous for kirtan and for chanting and dancing. And he was leading the kirtan, and there were many devotees all chanting and dancing around Haridas.
于是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 便开始了 kirtan， 有一名美妙的奉献者 Vakreshwara Pandit 就开始唱诵舞蹈，所有的奉献者环绕着 Haridas Thakur 开始跳舞歌唱。
And then they were having big kirtan. At one point, Lord Chaitanya began to describe about all the wonderful qualities of Haridas Thakur.And Lord Chaitanya was speaking like he had many, many mouths, and he was describing all the wonderful pastimes and activities of Haridas, how he chants the holy name every day 300,000 times. And the more he was describing Haridas, the happier Lord Chaitanya was becoming. It was ecstasy.
这样便有大声的 kirtan， 竹柴的念开始描述 Haridas Thakur 的美妙品质。当他描述之际，好像他有许许多多的口，他描述了 Haridas Thakur 的消时光，他的活动，说他每天念诵300,000次圣名。竹柴的念越描述，他的爹感到高兴，内心感到狂喜。
So then.All the devotees hearing about Haridas Thakur and his wonderful pastimes, they heard directly from Lord Chaitanya, they all offered their obeisances to Haridas Thakur.
所有的奉献者聆听了 Haridas Thakur 的品质，直接从主 Chaitanya 的口中 聆听了 Haridas Thakur 的品质和逍遥，他们都开始顶拜 Haridas Thakur。
So then Haridas Thakur had Lord Chaitanya come and sit down in front of him, and he fixed his eyes on the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he held the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya in his heart, and he took the dust of the feet of all the devotees present and put it on his head.
Haridas Thakur 让主 Chaitanya 坐在他的面前，双眼紧紧地凝视着主 Chaitanya 的莲花足。他将主 Chaitanya 的莲花足握住，放在自己的胸口，并且把所有奉献者莲花足的尘土撒在自己的头上。
And he began to chant the holy name Sri Krishna Chaitanya.Again and again he was chanting Sri Krishna Chaitanya, and he was holding the feet of the Lord and looking on the face of the Lord, and tears were falling down his eyes, tears were coming down his eyes, streaming down his face, and he was chanting Sri Krishna Chaitanya, and in this way he gave up his life, the air of life in the body left the body.
Haridas Thakur 开始唱诵圣名 Sri Krishna Chaitanya， 他反反复复一遍又一遍地唱诵着 Sri Krishna Chaitanya， 他抓住了主 Chaitanya 的莲花足，紧紧地凝视着主 Chaitanya 的莲花足，泪水如小溪如溪流一般就顺着他的脸颊流淌下来，他就唱诵着 Sri Krishna Chaitanya，就这样，生命之气就离开了他的躯体。
So all the devotees present, they could understand Haridas Thakur was giving up his body by his own desire, and it was just like Bhishma passing away. Grandfather Bhishma, he had the benediction that he would not die until he wanted to die, until he was ready to die. So the same way Haridas Thakur, he was giving up his body by his own desire.
放弃了他的躯体，正像老祖父毕士嘛，他得到了这个祝福，就是除非他自己想去世，他才可以离开。同样呢，哈尔达斯塔库也是因着他自己的意愿放弃了他的躯体。
So seeing Haridas Thakur give up his body, everyone chanted the holy name loudly, and they began to have more kirtan.And then Lord Chaitanya picked up the body of Haridas Thakur and he placed it on his lap. And he began to dance in the courtyard, holding the body of Haridas in his arms.
看着就是看到 Haridas Thakur 这样放弃了他的躯体，所有在场的奉献者开始高声地唱诵圣名，举行 kirtan。朱柴塔涅玛帕布抱起哈日达斯塔库尔的躯体放在自己的腿上，他 开始在这个院子里跳舞。如柴丹尼亚就这样抱着哈里达斯塔库尔的躯体。
So the devotees all took part in the kirtan. They were all ecstatic to dance and chant. Lord Chaitanya is holding the body of Haridas. And they did that for a little while. And then Swarup Damodar, who is the secretary of Lord Chaitanya, he came to Lord Chaitanya and said, now we have to do other things for the body of Haridas. We have to take care. We have to wash the body, and then we have to put the body in samadhi.
所有的奉献者都参加了 kirtan， 他们开始跳舞唱歌。就这样，朱柴丹尼亚抱着哈里达斯塔库尔的躯体，就跳了一会儿。过了一会儿，斯瓦入和达玛达尔，就是朱柴丹尼亚马巴布的秘书，来找朱柴丹尼亚说道：“我们要开始照顾哈里达斯塔库尔的躯体了，要为他来洗浴。”
So the body was carried to the sea, and the devotees were having kirtan all the time, chanting was going on, and Lord Chaitanya was dancing in front, and Vaikrishwara Pandit was dancing behind, and all the devotees were chanting the names, chanting and dancing, and Lord Chaitanya bathed the body of Haridas in the sea. And then he said, from this day on, the sea has become a pilgrimage site, a great holy place, a place of pilgrimage.
Haridas Thakur's 躯体就被带到了海里。在这与此同时呢， Kirtan 就一直的在继续着。朱柴丹尼亚抱着阿日达斯塔库尔的躯体在前面跳舞，把克里什瓦尔潘迪的紧随其后，所有的奉献者在那里高声地唱诵着圣名，在那里跳舞。朱柴丹尼亚马巴布亲手就为哈尔达斯塔库尔沐浴，在海里沐浴。柴丹尼亚马巴布说道：“从今天开始，这个海洋变成了一个朝圣之地，伟大的朝圣之地。”
So all the devotees, they drank the water that had touched the lotus feet of Haridas, the sea water. They began to drink it because they thought this water has all touched the feet of Haridas. It's very powerful. And they all drank it. And then they brought also sandalwood pulp from Lord Jagannath's temple, and they smeared that on the body of Haridas. Then they made a hole on the beach. They dug the sand to make a hole, and they placed Haridas Thakur's body in that hole. And they put also some remnants from Lord Jagannath, like from the Rath Yatra, there were some ropes which they used for pulling it. They put that with the body of Haridas, and then more sandalwood pulp and different cloth things were placed on the body.
奉献者就在海边挖了一个洞，就把挖沙子呢掏出来，把哈里达斯塔库尔的躯体放在了洞里。同时呢，他们还从扎格纳德的庙里带来了一些寄语，就是在弹车节的时候拉过弹车的那个绳子，还有一些檀香浆，以及与此同时有些布，都一起放在了这个洞里。
So Lord Chaitanya, he personally covered Haridasa Thakur's body with the sand. And all the devotees at that time, they're still having kirtan, and Vaikrishwara Pandit, he's dancing and chanting in ecstasy. And the devotees all put sand on the body of Haridas, and then they made a platform over the samadhi to protect it, put some fence around it to protect the place where his body was buried.
就在那里狂喜地唱诵着跳舞所有的奉献者就抓起海滩上的沙子开始掩埋哈尔达塔库的躯体他们在这个就是他的躯体上面建了一个平面同时呢又用篱笔围起了这块地方来保护哈尔达塔库的躯体
So then they had more kirtan and they circumambulated around the place where the body was buried. They went round several times and then they all went to took their bath in the sea after the funeral, after everything. They all have to take bath in the sea. And then Lord Chaitanya went to personally beg from all the shopkeepers saying that Haridas has left the world, we have to have a feast in his honor. And he asked all the people to donate for the festival.
奉献者们就这样围绕着哈尔达塔库的这个他围绕着这个现场呢开始 kirtan 他们就这样绕着这个地方 kirtan 了好几次之后呢 奉献者们就纷纷地去海里沐浴因为在这个葬礼之后呢人理应到海水里当中沐浴随后主差丹尼玛巴布开始挨家挨户地到每个商店的店主那里恳求店主给一些布施他告诉这些店主因为哈尔达塔库已经离开了引进了所以他们要举行大餐恳求这些店主来开始布施
So all the shopkeepers, they were very happy to give. They all wanted to donate something for the festival. And so it was arranged. Devotees would collect. They told them, give different things. Give some. Don't give all the same thing. Give different varieties of things so that we can make a nice feast. So it was arranged. Some devotees would carry everything. And then we went. They brought everything to the place where Haridas Thakur was buried, and all the devotees sat there, and they had a big festival.
就这样，这些店主们他们都很高兴，拿出布施来举行这个节日。奉献者们就安排说，你们不要给一样的，你们都要拿出不同的这些食物。就这样呢，我们可以好举行个大餐，就奉献者们。 就拿来了这些大餐带到了哈尔达塔库的这个萨玛迪的地方他们坐下来开始荣耀大餐
And so when they began to serve prasadam, Lord Chaitanya also wanted to serve the prasadam. But they said, no, you have to eat. If you don't eat, none of us can eat. So they had Lord Chaitanya sit down and take prasadam. And once Lord Chaitanya began to eat, then only the other devotees could take prasadam.
奉献者开始派布沙的主柴丹尼亚也想派布沙的但是奉献者们就告诉他不您应该坐下来除非您第一个坐下来荣耀的话其余的奉献者都不肯坐下来荣耀所以就这样他们让主柴丹尼亚妈妈坐下来
So Lord Chaitanya would encourage the devotees to eat more, take more, give him more, and made sure all the devotees had a lot and they were fully satisfied.
主柴丹尼亚就鼓励奉献者接受更多的要多吃点就这样奉献者们就荣耀了大量的布沙的他们感到心满意足
So all the devotees were told to eat up to the neck
所有的奉献者都被告知要吃到这个嗓子眼儿。
So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu then gave a benediction which satisfied all the devotees. He said that anyone who has seen the passing, who has seen the festival of Harinath Thakur passing away, then their lives are successful. Said they will achieve the favor of Krishna. They will get Krishna's mercy very soon. Anyone who chants and dances here, anyone who offers sand on the body of Haridas, anyone who has joined the festival to take prasadam, they will all get the mercy of Krishna very soon. Lord Chaitanya said Krishna was very kind that he gave me the association of Haridas, but it's also his own desire. He has now taken away that association. Lord Chaitanya said, Haridas Thakur wanted to leave the material world. I could not stop him. He said, Haridas gave up his body just like Bhishma, who also could choose his own desire. It was his own desire when to leave the world. Haridas Thakur was like a great jewel on the crown, but now he's gone, we don't have that jewel anymore. We've lost a very great jewel.
Haridas Thakur, 就像王冠上的一颗伟大的珠宝，现在他已经离开了，我们失去了这颗无价的珠宝。
So then Lord Chaitanya said, Haridas Thakur ki jai. And everyone began to chant and they had a big kirtan. And in this way, Haridas Thakur's disappearance is described. Okay, are there any questions?
How to the Muslim they eat?
They eat cow meat. Yeah.
And sheep. And they also offer after killing them. So how to regard this, their deeds? Also, is Muhammad the creator of Islam? Muhammad, did he encourage all these Muslims to eat meat?
Well, as far as I know, the Muslim religion, they're supposed to eat halal meat. Halal meat is meat without blood.
据我所知呢，这些穆斯林，被告知要吃 halal 肉。halal 肉的意思就是那些没有血、无血的肉。
Lord Chaitanya had a discussion with the Chankazi, you know, and the discussion, Lord Chaitanya, he didn't talk about taking goat meat or that, but he talked about killing cows. He said killing cows is not proper. We're concerned about that. Cow protection is very important. We don't approve any killing of the cow, because cow is a very important creature. Animal in the society.
Chankazi 曾经和朱彻丹尼亚马巴布有一个讨论，当时没有涉及到这个羊肉的问题，就只涉及到了杀母牛的问题，因为我们关心的是要保护母牛，杀牛是非常不对的，就是保护母牛是非常重要的一件事。
So there are many Muslims who are vegetarian. It's not that all Muslims are meat eaters. There are Muslims who are vegetarian. And so we don't encourage meat eating. And if somebody can be a vegetarian in the Muslim tradition, then that's also appreciated and respected.
有不吃肉的，有素食的穆斯林，我们是不鼓励，就是肉食的。如果就是有吃素的穆斯林的话，我们是非常欣赏他们的这个举动，也非常尊敬他们。
The message of the Quran is very similar to the message of Bhagavad Gita. There are many parallel statements.
古兰经的信息。和博家梵歌的讯息很类似，有很多经文都是平行的。
So, Lord Chaitanya, that when Lord Chaitanya spoke to the Chankazi agreed that people today in the Islam tradition they don't follow their scriptures carefully; they just simply.Eat without considering what they're eating. But he said there are many statements in their scriptures which indicate what should be done and what should not be done. But people in general, they don't care to follow. They just eat.
Chankazi and Chu Chaitanya, they were talking about the time, they agreed that in the time, Muslims.他们并没有小心地遵守经典经文当中的这些教导，他们并不在乎他们吃的是什么，但是经典里有经典里有严格的规定，应该做什么，不应该做什么。可是普通的人呢，他们并不在乎。
We're preaching Krishna consciousness, and Krishna consciousness preaches about mercy, and mercy should be given to all living entities. So we don't approve of killing animals wholesale, that we don't approve of the slaughter of animals. raising animals just for slaughter. If the people want to eat meat, they should wait till the animal dies naturally, and then they can eat the animal after it's dead. They don't need to kill the animal. They need to wait for the animal to die. Once the animal dies natural death, then they can eat the animal. They want to eat the animal. They want to eat animal flesh so badly, so wait for the animal to die, and then eat.
我们传播的是Krishna之觉，要对众生，一切众生要仁慈，我们并不赞成宰杀动物，就是为了屠杀动物来豢养这些生畜，如果一个人他特别想吃肉的话，要等待这个动物自然死亡之后，再吃这个动物的肉，我们不希望呢，就是。 有这种就是屠杀动物的行为，要等到动物死之后呢，再吃他们的肉。倘若有人特别的想要吃肉的话。Any
other question?
下一个 Panchatattva Das Limbai Guru 感谢翻译主持人 Haridas Thakur 为什么会遭受这么多苦难？ 他那把五兄弟也遭受很多苦难，这是Krishna的考验吗？奉献者如何面对人生苦难呢？
Yeah, we have to expect difficulties. Prabhupada said the fact that there are difficulties, this shows that this is actually a genuine religious process.
我们应当期待，期望。
The materialistic people, those who are absorbed in the bodily concept of life and are attached to sense gratification, will certainly oppose the genuine spiritual process and they'll make difficulties for the practitioners of spiritual life.
是的，那些物质主义者呢，他们完全专注于躯体的享乐，他们会反对真正的灵修方法，并且给这些真正的修习者制造困难。
We have to expect there will be difficulties, there will be challenges, there will be obstacles, but these difficulties will strengthen us. It will help us to become stronger, to become more fixed in our faith.
应当期望着有困难、有挑战、有障碍，但这一切呢，只会强化我们，让我们更加坚强，专注于我们自己的信念。
The difficulties which we undergo give us the greatest pleasure. That easygoing life of sense gratification, that is not good for us. But when we undergo difficulties, that will make us stronger and will give us more strength to face the ultimate difficulty, which comes when we have to give up the material body.
这些困难，我将给我们带来巨大的快乐。如果是那种轻轻松松的感官享乐的生活，那种生活是不好的。但是这些困难会增强我们的力量，会增强我们的信念。当我们在最终的时候放弃我们。 自己的躯体的时候，当我们面临这个放弃躯体的困难的时候，我们就会有强大足够的力量和信心。
We can't think there won't be trouble. Everywhere there will be trouble because this is the nature of the material world. Dukkhalayam ashashvatam, a temporary place of misery. That there is misery here in this material world. It's going to come. You can't avoid it. we have to just be fixed in our consciousness of Krishna, and we can overcome all these difficulties.
不能指望没有麻烦，这个物质世界就是 dukkhalaya shashvata， 是短暂而又悲惨的世界。来到这个物质世界，这些是都是无法避免的。我们应当专注于 Krishna 之觉，克服所有这些困难。
So yeah, there are tests, but the ultimate test comes when we have to leave the world, that we can leave everything, we can just take shelter, full shelter of Krishna and go back to God.
确实会有考验，终极的考验是在离开这个世界的那一刻，我们要放下一切，脱避于 Krishna， 回归神手。
还有问题吗？
下一个问题，萨提，皈依奉献者才能皈依哦，皈依奉献者才能皈依 Krishna 吧？才能皈依 Krishna。
是因为不知名的奉献者问，不是吗？
啊啊！
皈依奉献者什么？Yes, if the devotee is a representative of Krishna, then surrender to Krishna and surrender to the devotee is the same thing.
是的，倘若这奉献者是 Krishna 的代表，皈依 Krishna 和皈依奉献者是一样的。下一个是弹车节期间，哈尔达斯塔库没时间念诵192圈吧？
弹车一天没有时间。
就 Radha Yatra during Radha Yatra，
没有时间念诵。We never heard this. Nobody ever said. Haridas Thakur never said, "Oh, I didn't have time to chant."
我没听说过，从来没听说过。Haridas Thakur。也从来没有说过他为什么没时间念诵192圈。
Every day is chanting, you know. Okay, he go to Ratiyatra, he chant and dance, and then when Ratiyatra is over, he continues chanting.
他每天都在念诵，弹车节的时候，哈尔达塔库尔就去，高歌起舞，然后等结束之后，他又回来继续念诵。
He didn't have time for sleeping and eating.
他没有时间来吃睡。
He didn't sit and talk. He's chanted. He just chanted the holy name.
他没有坐在那里闲聊，他只是在那里念诵。
He was not interested. What's going on in the world?What's the politics? What's happening? How many people have got the COVID? How many people are dying? He knows all these things. He doesn't worry about all these things.
Ordinary people, their body will be better. buried to the ground. The difference is that those sadhus, they don't attach to the body, but ordinary person, they attach to the body. Also, what will be the result? Of they both buried to the ground, is it that the ordinary people are more encouraged to be the body, their body is more encouraged to be burned?
Well, yeah, ordinary people, at least in Vedic culture, the bodies are burned. They don't keep them around, they just burn the bodies, dead bodies.
就会被烧掉，他们不会留着这个躯体。
But the saintly person, like the Haridas Thakur, the great saintly person, their body is put in samadhi. They put the body in the ground.
然而，像 Haridas Thakur 这样的圣人的躯体是放在 samadhi 当中，不会烧。
Of course, in Christianity as well as in Muslim tradition, they have the culture, they will put everybody in the ground, they bury everybody.
在穆斯林和伊斯兰教当中呢，他们的文化就是，把那个人去世之后就土葬，他们不会火葬。
And so it's different cultures and different societies. For the Muslim, it's very important to be buried, to get a place, you know, buried. They don't do that. They don't do cremation. There's another religion they have in India called Parsi, and they don't burn the body because they worship fire. They say fire is very pure. So what they do with the dead bodies, they just feed it to birds.
有另外一门宗教叫 Parsi, 他们崇拜火，那当地人呢，他们就不会火葬，他们认为火是纯净的。
And the vultures are there and they come and they eat the dead bodies.
就秃鹰，他们会把这个躯体呢就分成小块儿，喂给就飞过来，就天上飞的那些秃鹫。
So in different places, different cultures, they have different methods of disposing of the body.
不同的地方，不同的文化，都有不同的处理躯体的方式。
Any other questions?
下一个问题是来自于潘继东，顶拜咕噜翻译你好，Krishna 化身佛陀，是释迦牟尼佛吗？
Well, I don't know. There are many different Buddhas. There are different Buddhas. Yeah. In Srimad Bhagavatam, there is one Buddha described. There's one Buddha described, and it gives the place of his birth. And it said he comes to lead the people away from killing the animals.
我不知道，有不同的佛陀。圣严伯伽瓦谈当中描述了一位佛陀，并且指出了他的出生地，他。
So, it's not clear who is the Buddha, which Buddha is she talking about?
Sakyamuni.
You have to check where was he born. who was his mother, then you can check with the Bhagavatam. Is it the same as what's in the Bhagavatam? I don't know. Any other question?
下一个是来自昌这位拉斯尼 Devadasi 顶拜孤乳莲花族顶拜奉献者们请教孤乳您刚才讲到哈尔达塔库根据自己的意愿离开物质世界孤乳在全世界传播 Krishna 圣名也是 Krishna 亲爱的仆人那么现在的冠状病毒也有孤乳被染上是也想离开这物世界吗还是可以这样理解
Did the Guru leave because he wanted to leave?
And now there are Guru who has also affected with COVID-19. Is it that this Guru is also willing to leave this material world? Or should we understand that the Krishna will strengthen our attachment, our love to Guru through prayer for this Guru?
Yes, that's definitely true, that Krishna will strengthen the attachment for the spiritual teacher by prayer.
是的，就是确定无疑的是 Krishna 想
At the same time, you have to remember the body is temporary. It's not going to live forever. So sometime it's going to leave the world. We have to develop the attachment for the instruction of the Guru, not just for the body.
躯体是短暂不恒的早晚有一天要离开我们要依附孤儿的训示而不是依附孤儿的躯体
Of course we like to have the Guru present, the spiritual teachers present because they can do many things and they have a lot of important service to do but we have to see what Krishna's plan is
我们当然希望灵性导师就在世因为灵性导师可以做许多事情很多服务但是我们还要看 Krishna 的计划
When the Guru suffers, it's not due to his karma but it's arrangement of Krishna when you get some disease like that Krishna's arrangement, it may be due to the sins of his disciples that he's become diseased like this. Maybe the reactions because he's accepted so many disciples, so he carries the reactions from his disciples.
Guru 受苦并非是 karma 因果，而是 Krishna 的安排。也有可能呢是由于门徒犯罪。
So the devotees, spiritual teachers, they also can get sick, they can also get disease. Krishna is showing us that just because you're a devotee doesn't mean that you won't get sick, doesn't mean you won't get diseased. But the question is, how do you deal with it? How do you tolerate it? And do you continue to chant? And do you go on worshipping Krishna? Or do you think, oh, Krishna didn't protect me, I don't have faith in Krishna anymore? Of course, that's not very good. If you give up your faith, you're thinking, Krishna didn't protect me, I don't have faith anymore, that's very poor. But you see the pure devotees, they go on, undisturbed. They continue with their hearing and chanting. They accept whatever situation Krishna puts them in. So the pure devotees are showing the example. When they're put into these conditions, sometimes it's so they can teach other people how to respond to these situations.
纯粹的奉献者就给人们树立了一个榜样，就教育别人该怎样回应这种状态。
Take more shelter of Krishna. Okay, any other question?
下一个问题是来自手机YY新人，顶拜咕噜和翻译， 那 Krishna 为什么不对他的奉献者多些顺利呢？ 这样他们也好影响周围的人， 难道非要奉献者遭受苦难吗？ 周围人看这些相信的奉献者都受苦， 没钱又生活又不顺利， 不就是会把那些信，就是想信奉的人都会吓跑了吗？ He asked why Krishna don't make this devotee's life more smooth, more easy. In that way, the people around them will see that if they see that the devotee's life is so have so much suffering and so much that they are so poor and their life is not very smooth, then the people around will be scared and will go away. So why Krishna don't make the life of devotee very smooth?
Well, Krishna wants to encourage everyone. You have to understand nature of this world, that life is not smooth for anybody in this world. There's always going to be troubles, there will be difficulties. So a devotee also cannot think because he's a devotee there won't be trouble. But the difference is how we face the trouble and how we deal with the trouble when it comes. Everyone's suffering in this world. The devotee doesn't think they're suffering more than others. Some people are rich and some are poor. It's not that all devotees are poor. It's going to be different for different. Some people suffer more than others. The Pandavas suffered for some time, not all their lives, but for some time.
Just 人会遭遇更多的麻烦，会比普通人受更多的苦。嗯，也有奉献者生活很富裕，也有生活贫穷的奉献者。奉献者他们有一段时间受苦，像潘的五兄弟，他们受苦只是一段时间，并不是他们从始至终一辈子都在那受苦。
Pandavas ended up ruling the whole world.
那最终潘杜五子他们统治了全世界。
So Krishna, according to the Krishna considers what's good for the different devotees. For some devotees, sometimes for some devotees suffering is there, not for all devotees. So Haridas Thakur, he considered that he was beaten in the marketplace. He said this was because of my offense. He said because I listened to so much blasphemy of Vishnu. I heard the Muslim king and the Muslim Qazi, I heard them blaspheme Lord Vishnu so many times and I didn't protest. So I should have protested more. Therefore, I got a punishment. I got beaten. So one has to learn tolerance, to understand these reactions which come due to our past sins, from past lives and past sinful activities, so we get suffering. Can't expect to avoid that. Can't think because I'm a devotee so there's no disease. No, there's still disease. Even though you're a devotee, there's still disease and we can get the disease. Don't think just because I'm a devotee I won't get the disease. No, and that's stupid. Just like if there's a tiger in the jungle, are you going to go in the jungle and think I'm a devotee, Krishna's in the heart of the tiger, Krishna won't let the tiger eat me? Then you're stupid.
就奉献者，不是说当奉献者就不会生病了，不要以为就只要是奉献者，他们就没事儿，不会生病。这个想法是愚蠢的想法。就是丛林当中会有老虎，不要以为我是奉献者 ，Krishna 在老虎的心中，他就不会让这个老虎吃掉奉献者，这是愚蠢的。
So we take precautions to protect ourselves, but some things, of course, we cannot protect, but we're not able to avoid. Just like we're not able to avoid getting old, we're not able to avoid disease and death.
We're not able to avoid disease and death. We're not able to avoid disease and death. We're not able to avoid disease and death. We're not able to avoid disease and death. We're not able to avoid disease and death.疾病无法避免的，死亡是无法避免的。
Sudama was very poor. Krishna gave him a huge, big palace. He gave him so much wealth.
Sudama, 他是本来以前他是一贫如洗的，后来呢 ，Krishna 就赐给他一座。
He didn't want it though, he didn't like that. But Krishna said, no, you have to take it, I'm giving it to you. But Krishna said, you have to take it.
But Krishna said, no, you have to take it. 受这些宫殿，你必须要接受这些财富。
So we have to accept whatever situation Krishna puts us in. Krishna's mercy. Thank you, Krishna.
无论 Krishna 把我们置于什么样的境况，我们都得接受。Krishna， 谢谢你。
It's all temporary, these situations in the material world, they're all temporary, not eternal. We have to understand our real home is in the spiritual world. You want to enjoy an eternal life of bliss and knowledge and opulence, go to the spiritual world. You don't get it here in this world, it's in the spiritual world. You have to go back home, back to Godhead. There you'll get the perfect life. So we accept a little bit of difficulty here in this life so that we can get the eternal life of opulence, of bliss and knowledge. The miseries are only temporary. And so we accept that for some time to get the eternal life. Do you understand, Mary, the person who asked this question? You understand? Okay, any more questions?
下还有一个，还有 Rasa 提的问题，顶拜 Guru， 如果我们主动自愿的做一些苦行 ，Krishna 会根据我们取悦他的程度，相应的减少我们过往业报本来应该承受的苦难吗？我们看到纯粹奉献者都做过减少躯体的需求，甚至不吃不喝也从事服务，而我们每天。做饭、吃饭、洗碗要花好几个小时，我们把这时间省下来做服务，要比为 Krishna 每天做大餐更取悦他吗？嗯，a business guru, if we voluntarily do some tapasya, will Krishna reduce our past karmic reaction?Suffering we should have endured for our past karma, we see that the pure devotee, they all fast from eating and drinking to do more devotional service, and we are busy with cooking and washing for many hours. Can we save those times to do service? More pleasing to Krishna than doing those big feasts.
Well, what are you going to do to please Krishna?
那您为了取 Krishna， 您打算做什么呢？ Yeah, well, Krishna is pleased when we, you know, Krishna also eats, you know. You have to understand Krishna is a person and he also eats.
So we don't cook just for ourselves, but we cook for Krishna. And so you're cooking for Krishna, you still want to cook a feast. And that's one way in which you can please Krishna. You cook a nice feast and you can please Krishna. If you're not going to cook, if you're just going to cook very simply, then I don't know, will Krishna be so pleased? We shouldn't be lazy. We shouldn't think that, oh Krishna, I'm too tired, I don't want to do all that cooking and cleaning. But we accept all that cooking and cleaning on behalf of Krishna, because we're cooking for Krishna, to please Krishna. So, cooking a feast and offering to Krishna doesn't mean you have to eat a big feast. It's not just for you to eat, it's for Krishna. And we should be happy to cook for Krishna and be happy to serve it all to the devotees. Give service to the devotees, you please the devotees. That's a very nice thing to do. You get the mercy of the devotees. Keep the devotees happy, cook for them. Not that you have to eat everything. You don't need to eat at all. You can fast. But you should help to cook and serve and clean, because that's service. You're cleaning the heart. You're getting the mercy of devotees. So, don't go away from devotional service. You know, we want to be active in devotional service, and cooking is one of the ways in which we can please Krishna. Cooking, offering to Krishna, it's pleasing. Remember, but Krishna wants devotion. It's not the big feast, but it's the devotion. So, the mood in which you prepare the food for Krishna is also very important. So, if you grudgingly or reluctantly go in the kitchen, it's not very good. You must have the right service attitude. Prasadam is very important in distributing Krishna consciousness. Many people become devotees because of prasadam.
Krishna
And many people, they'll come to the programs just simply to have prasadam.
许多人来参加几度呢，只是冲着普沙南的。
So we don't want to stop cooking prasadam.
所以我们不希望停止做普沙的。
Okay, any other question?
还有下一个是 Madhusudan Das， 还有 Madhusudan Das。哈尔达斯塔库的前世是谁？是给地球人做榜样的吗？来 ，What's the previous life of Haridas Thakur? Is he come?、did he come to set example for the people in this Bhumi?
Well, there are different opinions, but in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, he's described as Brahma Haridas.So in his previous life, he was Lord Brahma.
So, 有不同的意见。在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 当中描述他是 Brahma Haridas， 所以他前世是主 Brahma.
Lord Brahma had been offensive to Krishna by stealing away his cows and cowherd boys. So he prayed to Krishna.In your next incarnation, give me a humble birth. I won't be so proud. Because I'm Brahma, I'm very proud. So in your next incarnation, allow me to come in a humble way and let me develop humility. So he took birth in his Mohammedan family and he chanted the holy name and showed example of humility and tolerance. Okay. Any other question?
还有下一个是 Jagateshwari Devadasi。顶拜 Gurudev 感恩翻译。Haridas Thakur 是一个伟大灵魂，有很多考验，树立了光辉榜样，得到 Chaitanya 和 Krishna 的仁慈。请问 Gurudev，今后我们怎么做才能永远处在纯粹少年形态，度过自己的一生呢？
Haridas Thakur is a great sage.
Yeah, he had passed many tests and set a good example, glorious example for the people who later born. And he also got mercy from Lord Chaitanya and Krishna.So my question is that, what should we do from now on? We can eternally be situated in the level of pure goodness and pass this life.
Yes, well, we have to chant the holy name. Just like Haridas was chanting, we also have to take shelter of the holy name.Haridas Thakur said, even you cut my body to pieces, I will never give up chanting the holy name.
Haridas Thakur, 当初说，如果你们把我的躯体切成碎尸万段，切成千万段，我也不会放弃唱诵主的圣名的。
And he told Lord Chaitanya, my disease is, I have not been able to complete my chanting.So we all have to take care to make sure we chant every day our 16 rounds minimum.
We all have to take care to make sure we chant every day our 16 rounds minimum.
OK， 还有问题吗？
还有Sitarani Devadasi， Hare Krishna 顶拜 Guru 感恩甜美翻译。Hare Das Thakur 的显现净化我们的内心，而我们可不是 Hare Das Thakur， 每天只能念诵有限卷数。我们可以祈祷 Hare Das Thakur 再次降临，如果被鞭打致死又再复活消失光再次上演，是不是可以有力地征服当权者，开展齐颂圣名运动呢？还是说消失光演到这儿有别的安排别的情节？我们应该向 Hare Das Thakur 祈祷什么呢？The appearance of Hare Das Thakur purified our heart, but we are not Hare Das Thakur. We can only chant limited rounds. Can we first pray that Hare Das Thakur can descend again if he's beaten to death and then he revived again? This Leela appeared again. It will be a very strong, can convince the authority very effectively, and so that we can spread this Sankirtan movement. Or is that this Leela only end up here, and there's other arrangement, other arrangement? What should we pray?Pray to Hare Das Thakur.
Yes, we're not going to have that arrangement again. He's not going to come again and be beaten again. He already did it one time. That's once is enough. We're not going to have him do that again. We simply have to pray to Hare Das Thakur, let me have faith in the holy name and let me chant the holy name. Let me complete my chanting, my 16 rounds.
We just need to pray to Hare Das Thakur, please let me have faith in the holy name, please let me chant the holy name, please let me complete my 16 rounds.
So Lord Chaitanya gave him the position Namacharya, is it the Acharya in the chanting of the holy name. So we pray to him like that.
Chu Chaitanya 就赐予他 Namacharya 这个封号，要唱诵圣名誓师，所以我们就这样向他祈祷。
Okay, any question more?
No.
Okay, so we can finish here. Sati? Jun Tian Dao Jer?
好的，我们今天就到这里。
感谢奉
献。
Thank all the devotees. 感谢奉献者。感谢 Guru Manik, Imam Fani, 感谢 Sati, Jun Jer. Okay, Wen Dao Jia Hao.
谢谢 Maharaj.
Hare Krishna, Guru Manik, 谢谢。
谢谢。
阿里波。
好
的。Good day, KJ。
KJ。
哎，可是。